the UK economy is doing better than they expected.
It is much better, and we heard yesterday, of course, all sorts of figures, unemployment, inflation. We heard about forecasts for the year ahead, but what do they all mean, and crucially, for what we earn? Yes, good morning to you. It does seem strange that the economy is growing, but we're not feeling that in our pockets, especially in what we earn. But why? Well, official figures show that unemployment rate, that fell again in the 3 months to June. There are now 130,000 fewer people out of work. Now, that's a good indicator that the economy is, of course, performing well. But at the same time, average earnings, not including bonuses, they've grown by just over 0.5%. That is the slowest rate since records began in 2001. Well, that feels even worse because the cost of living, that's inflation, it's already 1.9%. Well, that was reiterated by Mark Carney, the governor of the Bank of England. He was giving his update on the economy, and he said there wasn't much hope for wage rises despite the economy doing well.
Pay growth has been remarkably weak, even as unemployment has fallen rapidly. This may partly reflect lags. Whatever the causes, these developments point to the economy being able to sustain a higher level of employment and a lower rate of unemployment without generating additional inflationary pressures.
Mark Carney there. Now, the official figures, of course, won't come as any surprise to many families who are feeling a squeeze on their income, including Geraldine King. She's a charity worker from Liverpool.
We're relatively well paid, but even so, I haven't had a pay rise for several years here. My husband works for a big IT company, but he hasn't had a pay rise for several years either. I mean, we're not struggling the way that lots of people are around the country, but we have reduced the number of family visits we make to the cinema, because as a family of five, that costs quite a lot of money. We do one holiday a year, possibly not this year because we can't afford it.
And so here is the puzzle. In a healthy economy, wages do tend to go up because employers have to offer higher pay to attract workers. So why isn't that happening here?
There's two good reasons why wages aren't picking up. The first is the government's auto-enrolment in pensions programme. Now here, businesses are having to put money into employees' pension schemes, so that's increasing their costs. So essentially they are paying their employees more, but rather than going to their monthly pay packets, it's going into their pensions. The other is that the recovery hasn't really been getting going for that long, and people are still a little bit nervous and shy to pester their bosses for pay rises.
However, there is one bright spot on the horizon. I promise you there is one. If you've got a mortgage, the Bank of England governor suggested yesterday that low growth in wages could mean that the Bank of England delays raising interest rates. It would keep them at their historic low of 0.5% for a little bit longer. But of course, that's good news if you're a borrower, not good news if you're a saver. It's always that conundrum, isn't it?
It always is. OK, Ben, thanks very much.
Now, between Russia